Welcome to the lecture on the Indian Contract Act 1872. We daily hear the term called contract, but what does it actually mean? Seriously speaking, the contract is a part of our everyday life. Starting from purchasing a pen or pencil from a petty shop till the construction of a very big complex or a building, the contract takes place. As we all know, man is a social animal. He always depends on some other person or with the society to give and take services, and all these services is based on some trust or what can be simply called understanding. Every understanding will be based on some agreements. For example, I go to a stationery store, I purchase a book. There I have some understanding between the shopkeeper, and the shopkeeper has some trust on his customers. There, when the customer purchases the book, there is a trust and the contract is formed. Similarly, in whatever we do, in almost all the cases, we are entering into contracts knowingly or unknowingly. In all such cases, we can say that contract is a part of our everyday life. But we somehow got confused between the term agreement and a contract. An agreement is just understanding between the person, and a contract needs law. That is, an agreement needs the eyes of law to get it turned into a contract. To be more precise, we form the agreements, but the agreements which creates or which tells the rights and duties of both the parties involved into the agreement, it should be written in the form of writing. And the written agreement may differ from person to person and from dealing to dealing. So in all such cases, there will be a difficulty to give justice if there is any chances of cheating or breach. Seeing all this, our constitution members have an intention, and in order to solve these problems, they have come up with a separate act in the constitution called the Indian Contract Act, and it was passed on 1st of September 1872. So what is the Contract Act? The Indian Contract Act mainly consists of 266 sections.
So in all these 266 sections, the Contract Act has to
find some general principles related to contract, some general principles related to law, special cases which give an exemption to the general rules of a contract, and it is also spoke about the different types of contract like negotiable instruments, it may be bailer agreement, it may be indemnity agreement, and other such things. Technically speaking, this